There are new rules and regulations being proposed, mostly for your good, because it will make overall traffic assessment and management a lot more stringent, perhaps more streamlined. But therein lies a little bit of a caveat and a problem. What we're now getting to know is that while there would be all these stricter regulations and new, much higher fines as well, the necessary infrastructure to be able to implement all of this correctly, well, just doesn't exist around the country. Kingshuk Datta has more details on that.
Admit it, at one point in time have broken traffic rules. Most of us would have been caught by the traffic cops and paid a fine for the same. Some of us may have even tried to bribe the traffic cops in order to avoid paying the fines and the legal hassles. But what if you were caught and fined by the traffic cops because the traffic signs or signals were faulty? Now that would definitely pinch you, right?
Did you know that approximately 75% of the road signs, signals and markings in Delhi do not conform to the standards laid down by the authorities? With the new Motor Vehicle Act on the anvil, this poses a threat of sorts to the average motorist. Let's find out how.
Here are a few examples of some basic problems with the traffic signage in Delhi. There are many faulty traffic signals in Delhi. This one here, for example, shows all three lights going on at the same time. This could possibly cause inadvertent breaking of traffic laws and moreover, presents a danger for motorists as well. There are quite a few places in Delhi which have road signage but at the wrong places. This is a busy junction at a location in South Delhi. You can clearly see a pedestrian crossing sign, but there is no zebra crossing on the road. Where does the pedestrian cross from? Whenever you see double white lines in the middle of the road, it is almost equivalent to a divider and signifies that one cannot cross over to the other side. If you do, you would be breaking the law. But what if the marking was in the middle of an intersection where there's a traffic signal that allows you to take a right turn on the green light? Well, you would still be technically breaking a traffic rule with absolutely no fault of yours.
Primarily, everything which moves onto the road must have certain standards and codes of practice. The legislation of the road is based upon the standard practices of the environment. For example, if I say people must stop at stop signals at traffic lights, then the signals must be made as per what the standards require. For example, jumping a signal means jumping a stop line. Now, if the stop lines are not there, signals are wrongly placed, you cannot effectively obey the law.
IRTE did the study on 14 major roads in Delhi, which covered 85 kilometers and 1,514 traffic signals and signage. Of the traffic signage, at least 1,098 or 75% of them were found to be faulty and not meeting the required standards. The study said the color, size and shape code have been used interchangeably, which is not the correct way to go about it because it's making the road users cause traffic violations unknowingly. So there you go. If the state of affairs on Delhi roads is not rectified, you just might end up paying a hefty fine only because of incorrect road signs and faulty traffic signals. With the updated Motor Vehicle Act about to be implemented into law, the concerned authorities really need to rectify these faults at the earliest, because the only people who stand to suffer are hapless motorists.